Oh, I just beat BB. Hey guys, so right now it's like 7 in the morning. I woke up for no reason. I should have to get up early today, but I thought I'd shoot this quick video because I rewatched this unboxing you're about to watch, and I'd said some pretty terrible things about this game. So I thought I'd give you guys a review of the game before we actually start this unboxing and hear me bitching about the game, but basically, the game is not as bad as I said it was. I actually woke up like an hour ago and I started playing the BB version. I'm already done with it, so it shows you how long that game is, but the problem with that is that I don't read Japanese, so the story doesn't benefit me, but it was a pretty lengthy story. I just skipped all the text. What I don't like about it is that there isn't that much songs. There's only like 13, I believe. I'm not quite sure, but it's pretty ridiculous that I paid $60 to just play 13 songs, but I guess, like I said, the story's long, so if you can read Japanese, it's probably worth your time, but it doesn't benefit me in any way. I bring up graphical issues in this game. There isn't actually graphical issues, it's more like there's frame rate issues, and also I feel like the graphics can be, it's a little lazy, I feel like it could have been improved. It's kind of flat, even the bubbles that are supposed to be, you know, 3D and round, but the bubbles are actually like 2D, like paper flat. So in this unboxing I compare this game to Squirtle Festival for the iOS and Android, and that's because that game is like 10 times more fun than this one, and it's free, so I don't know what's up with that. I don't know, overall I don't think the game is as bad as I say it is. It's just, I just feel like it could have been a lot better, because there's three games in this set, and I feel like they're all kind of lazy. I feel like they could have, instead of working on three mediocre rhythm games, they could have made one big awesome one with all the girls, and you could choose the subgroup within that one big awesome. Like, I'm gonna compare it to some rhythm games right now, like Project Diva. There's like 30 or 40 something songs on there. It feels great. There's no slowdowns. Everything looks great. It's way better. The K-On! HD port from the PSP game, that has so many, way more songs than this, each game. And Muse has like 2 times more songs than K-On! Does. Except the K-On! Game isn't fun, that's the only problem with that one. Or I just don't know how to play it, that game is so weird for me. So yeah, that's pretty much my 2 cents on the game. Don't take my word for all the crap I say for it. You're here for the unboxing, I'm not a reviewer, sort of. So that's pretty much it. The game is not as bad as I say it is. I was just super disappointed with it. But if it's interesting to you, go ahead and check it out. You should look at gameplays and stuff before you know, decide on picking it up. Alright, I'm just gonna leave now. I don't feel well. I'll talk to you guys, or I'll see you guys in my next video. Enjoy. Hey guys, welcome back to my next unboxing. I recently just unboxed the Lily White version, and I've also done the printed version from months ago, so you can check that out by clicking, well, you know what, I'll just leave the links in the description and at the end of this video. Now that I got that out of the way, let's talk about the BB unbox. So the front, of course, we have BB, consists of Maki, Ellie, and Nico, and the front is, you know, the school in the background, the same crap as the other ones. It's really nice and colorful, which is great. And then on the side, we have Volume 2, BB, and, you know, just everything else, the same thing. The back, same thing as everything else in, like, you know, standard gaming back cases, where it just shows you the description of the game and what's inside the limited edition, which consists of 3 petite androids of the BB. And yeah, that's pretty much it, and let's get this thing unboxed. Once again, when you open it up, there's a nice illustration of all the girls from all 3 sets, or all 3 groups I should say. And first thing you'll see is the game itself. Okay, so now the game itself, like most video games from Nippon, it comes with little colorful pamphlets, and that's pretty much it. Here's some advertising for the iOS game, which is 10 times better than this game. But that's just my opinion, and the game itself, of course. And inside this big giant box in here is the Nendoroid Petites, which we'll take a quick look at. So I didn't go in much detail of the box itself on the Lily White, but it's practically really plain. It's just a white box with Squirtle Paradise all around the side, and a black and white pictures of the 300 petites that, well, that are inside. So let's just, you know, get this open. I'll go in a little more detail, even though this is kind of like pointless, because, well, it's 300 petites. If you haven't had 300 petites before, get ready, because these are gonna hurt your thumbs unless you're super skillful and know what you're doing. But I don't know how to really do this because I've broken a couple of these before because I'm dumb. So all the petites are covered in plastic and I don't want to lose these base here, so I'll just put them down for now. And we're just gonna cut right to it because I'm gonna set them up right now and I don't know how long it's gonna take because I suck with petites. So this is what the 300 petites look like once you open them up. They look super adorable. My only complaint is that Ellie and Maki took me like 10 minutes to put them together because, well, it's, I guess I shouldn't complain about it because it's my own problem. I just suck with putting petites together. But what I do really like is friggin' Nico. Nico looks so cute, and I'm not even a fan of Nico, but Nico honestly looks the best out of like the whole set, besides Rin. Rin is actually really cute too. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the 300 petites. Alright, so this was my limited edition BB version of the Squirtle Paradise Love Live PlayStation Vita video game unboxing. That is a long name. So overall, the box itself looks really beautiful. I love the colorfulness and the background of the school, and I love how all three sets combine into one big giant illustration art thingy. The game itself is crap, but that's just my opinion. I suggest you continue playing the iOS Squirtle Festival if you started already. If not, definitely go check it out. It's a great free game. And the petites itself are worth the pain because my thumbs are in serious pain right now. Specifically, Ellie and Maki took like 10 minutes just to put them together. I hate petites, but if it's Love Live, I gotta get it. So that's it. Hopefully, I helped you guys make a decision whether or not to pick up this game. And yeah, have a lovely day and see you guys in my next video.